गुड इवनिंग स्टूडेंट्स. सो नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट इलेक्ट्रिक ससेप्टिबिलिटी. द मीनिंग ऑफ ससेप्टिबिलिटी इज दैट हाउ मच अ मटेरियल कैन एक्वायर द चार्ज और व्हाट विल बी द इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड इन्फ्लुएंस व्हेन इट इज अप्लाइड ऑन द मटेरियल. सो इलेक्ट्रिक ससेप्टिबिलिटी इज दैट इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड एक्चुअली व्हाट इफेक्ट्स इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड और व्हाट इफेक्ट्स द डाइलेक्ट्रिक मटीरियल. So the polarization is directly proportional to the electric field. So in a dielectric material, more will be the polarization, that more will be the applied electric field. Okay. So dipole moment is going to be more indirectly when the electric field is getting high. So P is proportional to E, and when you will remove this proportionality sign, then two constants are going to be introduced. One is epsilon naught and one is xi. Epsilon naught you already know, permittivity of the medium, and xi is the susceptibility, that how much electric field can influence it or what will be the effect of electric field on the material. So xi is electric susceptibility. Now students, what will be the value of xi from this relation? Suppose we calculate the value of xi, then xi will be P upon epsilon naught E. Okay, so by this relation we can actually define psi. Okay, susceptibility can be defined as the ratio of polarization, in the numerator there is polarization, to epsilon naught time the electric field is known as susceptibility of the dielectric. So this is how we can define electric susceptibility. Now students, there is a very important relation, that is relation between K and psi. Okay, this you have to understand. What is K? K is dielectric constant or relative permittivity, we have studied. And what is xi? Right now we have studied the electric susceptibility. So there is a relation between these two, and which is often asked in the board exam, so you have to go through it. So what is the relation? The net electric field in a polarized dielectric is, what is the net electric field? The answer is very clear if you have seen the previous videos. E is equal to the total field which we have applied, E original minus EP. What is EP? The polarized field. Why it was introduced? Because of the dielectric material when slab was placed in between the two parallel plates of the capacitor. I hope you understood this. Okay, so E is E naught minus EP. Now what is the value of EP? Polarized field. So electric field, already we know that for a plate, by application of Gauss theorem we have studied, EP is equal to sigma P upon epsilon naught. Okay, for one plate the electric field is sigma upon epsilon naught. So but this plate is getting the charge because of polarization, so that is why EP will be sigma P. The notation will be sigma P upon epsilon naught. Now students, sigma P is charge density, but in the previous derivation I have proved that charge density is numerically equal to polarization density. So in place of sigma P I have replaced it by polarization density divided by epsilon naught. So E is equal to E naught minus EP. In place of EP we are substituting P upon epsilon naught. Okay, now E is equal to, we can see E naught minus, in place of this polarization density, what is the value of polarization density? Okay, that is epsilon naught xi E. Okay, polarization density is equal to epsilon naught xi E. So substitute this value on the numerator. So E is equal to E naught minus epsilon naught xi E upon epsilon naught. Okay, epsilon and epsilon naught gets cancelled out, and now divide all the equation by E. So what will be E upon E? 1. E naught upon E, E naught upon E. Epsilon naught and epsilon naught gets cancelled out. E upon E gets cancelled out. We will get only xi. So 1 is equal to, what is the ratio of E naught and E? The ratio of original field to the net electric field is known as dielectric constant. So we can replace E naught upon E by K. So 1 is equal to K minus xi. So K is equal to 1 plus xi. So this is going to be the relation between K and Z, dielectric constant and the electric susceptibility. So I hope you understood this. Thank you. God bless you.